गेट रेडी फॉर 160 वर्ड पर मिनट शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन। स्टार्ट। द पर्पस ऑफ ए स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन इज टू एक्सप्लोर द इंटेंट एंड द एलिज्ड इलीगैलिटी और प्रोसीड्यूरल लैकुना दैट द गवर्नमेंट डिसीजन इन क्वेश्चन हैज सॉट टू कैमोफ्लेज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड एक्सप्रेशंस यूज्ड इन द आंसर। द ओरल सप्लीमेंटरी क्वेश्चंस सीक टू अनरेवल दीज। इट इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ वर्बल जिमनास्टिक्स नॉट अननोन इन डेली लाइफ। परहैप्स ग्रेटर सेंसिटिविटी टू पार्लियामेंट्री एंड पब्लिक सेंटीमेंट्स कुड हैव बीन डिस्प्लेड बाय एक्सप्लोरिंग प्रोसीड्यूरल ऑप्शंस दैट वुड रिटेन द सब्सटेंस इफ नॉट द कंप्लीट फॉर्म ऑफ ए स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन। One way could be to admit the start question, rely to it in a set of propositions and allow the member concerned to table in writing the permitted number of follow-up questions also to be answered in writing the following day. Were these options explored and discussed with the leaders of political parties and groups? The chairman and the speaker unquestionably have the final word on matters relating to the proceedings of their respective houses. This can be and has been supplemented on occasions by using a motion to develop consensus on matters of general public interest. Was this explored on this occasion? And finally, what public purpose is served when senior members of the ruling party prescribe the opposition expression of concern as a fake narrative since extraordinary times justify extraordinary measures? The test of a functioning democracy is its ability to face crisis, social, economic, political, and seek correctives premised on institution of democracy. A resort to what has been called the politics of avoidance does not help the process. Executive accountability upfront cannot be allowed to become a thing of the past. The Independence Day address of the Prime Minister launching the National Digital Health Mission NDHM during an unprecedented novel coronavirus pandemic crisis caught everyone's attention. Yet, despite all his eloquence, it was not clear to many what to expect in substantial terms. Going digital has no doubt been a magic phrase that has often been repeated in multiple contexts in the country, and as yet another mission for the health sector, they waited for more news to emerge. On August 27, we learnt that the Ministry of Health was expecting feedback and public comments on the draft by September 3rd. Since then, the date has been extended by another week. Even that leaves insufficient time for discussions among medical practitioners, hospital managements, associations of various stakeholders in the healthcare sector and the other member of civil society for any meaningful feedback. Some progress. There is no disputing the premise that capturing data relating to patients and its digitizing could help patients and the doctors who attend to them and the healthcare facilities where they seek treatment. In fact, many states have already achieved some breakthroughs in these areas with the National Rural Health Mission NRHM and subsequently National Health Mission through the IT network connected to most public health centers even in tribal areas. Personal health data are generated by name till the primary health center level but not transmitted to higher level except aggregated numerical data. Some patients get referred to stand-alone specialists or tertiary hospitals or diagnostic facilities and then they go back to their original practitioner or health center. They carry back with them hard copies of the reports or soft copies in their smartphones. Most practitioners, especially specialists, without data entry, staff often extract only the relevant notes and return the hard copies. All larger health facilities generate and store computerized patient data also for planning treatment, procurement of medicines and consumables. Most patients avail medical services from doctors or healthcare centers in their own state. But when they seek advanced care in other states or migrate to another state, have they not been deprived of medical care? Was it then for want of past records or for want of a national network or for want of a national policy on the issue? Ironically, many tertiary hospitals and medical colleges care little for diagnostic reports from peripheral centers or even the prescriptions of previous doctors. So what happens to all the cards created under the Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana and Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana? Currently for Pan India portability or for determining insurance cover, these cards were good enough without the need for the entire medical history at any centralized platform. Without pretending that all is hunky-dory now, one can still ask this. Is there a serious problem with the way patient-related information is managed today? Health is under the state list subject. So, did any state government ask for a national level digitization plan to help it in its tasks? Has there been a problem of not getting real-time state-wise aggregated data to the government of India? Have any associations of doctors or civil society organizations asked for digitization? Let us not brush aside the benefits from as plan of virtually Aadhaar-like proportions to digitize all data relating to all patients available not just with government and private hospitals, but also with the diagnostic centers, laboratories, and individual practitioners of all systems of medicine. The contours, the elegance of that proposed architecture can send anyone into a daze. An IT consulting firm has been engaged to build a national health stack and a registry of over 8 lakh doctors, 10 lakh pharmacists, and over 60,000 hospitals is under preparation. At a later stage, online pharmacies, insurance companies, and other stakeholders will be added to the stack. The strategy document states upfront that your data is safe and confidential and would be stored only locally. Only anonymized data will be shared upward and your consent will be taken every time for sharing any personal identifiable information. Among the many benefits listed are that it would help patients save the burden of carrying medical reports to a specialist or other hospitals. One can also avail telemedicine support from renowned specialists if required. And it will be a cakewalk to get your hospital's bills settled with insurance cover under government schemes or the higher value policies purchased by you. Overall, the scheme appears to promise an end-to-end hands-free digital experience. The scheme also intends to replace existing data generation system with a new homogenized software for all machines in the health sector in the country with a central processor that will extract the relevant data from individual records. There is a presumption that all the data entered in each patient's file is accurate. Even entries made for Aadhaar cards or voter ID cards have not been error-free. With all medical history recorded as truth in the new software, insurance companies would be looking for multiple ways to reduce their obligations, leading to many disputes. Extensive costs dilemma. On the face of it, from the side of healthcare institutions, the NDHM is merely ensuring customization of a new software and changes in current practices of data maintenance. However, it would become inevitable for all institutions in the government as well as private sector to upgrade their hardware too, apart from considerable costs in customization and transfer to existing data. In the government sector, there are many existing practices and systems for completion of data, as in the Integrated Disease Surveillance Program and the Health Management Information System IDSP HMIS, apart from all learning acquired over the years.